People seek a champion of justice who can and will defend and uphold the cause of justice. In Matthew 21, Jesus upholds God's justice in the temple, fulfilling Isaiah 42's vision of the Messiah. Isaiah came to the people with messages of judgment tempered with hope. He ministered for 60 years or more and prophesied during the reign of 5 kings of Judah. And that brings us to our verse for today, which reads, "Look at my servant whom I strengthen. He is my chosen one, who pleases me. I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring justice to the nations." Isaiah 42, verse 1. This servant is unique and differs from an ordinary servant as humans understand it. His uniqueness is demonstrated in the series of qualifying or identifying attributes and the special relationship he has with the Lord, God. He belongs to God. God will sustain and support him through his ministry. Christ had been chosen before time and eternity for the special task of redemption. The chosen one is also the one in whom God delights. The servant, the speaker says, has been endued with God's Spirit. The servant is equipped from eternity for a specifically assigned mission to bring judgment to the Gentiles. The servant's demeanor will differ from that of an ordinary person, such as the merchant who goes out advertising his wares with a loud voice on the street. As a teacher, he will speak with quietness and calmness. As a prophet, he will not proclaim his message with a loud voice or with sensationalism. Neither will he present his message argumentatively, i.e., he will not strive. Nor will he push his teaching down the throat of the people. He does not need to, because the Holy Spirit is the one who will convince them. His modesty and the quiet manner in which he carries out his mission are also reflected in his attitude toward and treatment of the weak. This is graphically expressed in the imagery of the reed and the smoking flax or the lamp wick. The servant will neither quench the flickering weak light nor break the already bruised reed, which is another way of saying that he will sustain and uphold the weak. His activities will be marked with gentleness, compassion, and mercy. The passage is applied to Jesus' healing ministry, affirming the servant will not fail or be discouraged, implies that the ministry of the servant will not be easy. He will encounter difficulties and resistance. This is expressively prophesied of him that he was wounded and bruised. However, he will never grow weary or faint, nor will he be discouraged, but he will continue conscientiously until he accomplishes his task, until he establishes mishpat in the earth. Isaiah 42 verse 5 is transitional in nature. The prophet appeals to the person of God as the creator and sustainer of all things. The one speaking is the one that gives breath and spirit to all people on earth. He is the Lord, the covenant-keeping God of Israel, the one who is faithful to keep his promises and never fails. With such a God behind him, the servant cannot fail or be discouraged, even in the face of obstacles or resistance. This mission will have its foundation in God's righteousness. Not only has God called him in righteousness, but he will also hold the servant's hand and keep him. The clause, "and give thee for a covenant of the people," states the purpose of the servant's mission. Being a covenant and a light implies more than being the source through which salvation comes to the people. The servant is the embodiment of the covenant and light, the origin and dispenser of the covenant and the radiance of light in himself. Therefore, the task of the Messiah, called the light, is to open their eyes from sin. This assurance of God's faithfulness in keeping his promises is further stated in the last two phrases of this verse, which are synonymous. "My glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images." This is to say that what I promise, I will perform. He will not let the servant down. Confident in the faithfulness of the Lord to keep his promises even before they spring forth, Isaiah calls on the people, both Jews and Gentiles, and all who would hear this prophecy, indeed the whole earth, to start celebrating by singing a new song to the Lord. Here's our lesson. Think about the new heavens and earth that God has promised us. Let's spend time this week rejoicing in the fact that one day injustice and oppressive systems will be gone and that God's righteous judgment will be the standard for all. We pray for you that you remain healthy and safe. Heavenly Father, fill our hearts with what we truly desire, for who we truly seek is you.